राधानाथ स्वामी नामिने नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रष्टाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पश्चात्य देश तारिणे ओम ज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुर्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितमेन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकम्। वंदेगम श्री गुरु श्रीयुत पद कमलम श्री गुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्री रूपं साग्रजातं सगगन रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सगगन ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधु जगतपदे गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। ईश्वरा परम कृष्णा सच्चिदानंद विग्रह अनादि राधिर गोविंदा सर्व कारण कारणम हरे कृष्ण। माय लॉर्ड श्री कृष्णास कॉसलेस मर्सी। वी आर नाइसली स्टडीइंग भगवद गीता एंड नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन द फोर्थ चैप्टर ऑफ भगवद गीता। Every Saturday evening, US time, and Sunday morning, India time, we are in the fourth chapter. Otherwise, we are in the 11th chapter in the universal form Vishwarupa. So in the fourth chapter, we finished 24 slokas, which has got 42 slokas, the fourth chapter. So almost nearly half of the chapter we finished, little more than half of the fourth chapter we have finished. In the fourth chapter, Krishna is teaching. This is titled as the transcendental knowledge, the fourth chapter, because Krishna is giving more information about this Bhagavad Gita. How, why this Bhagavad Gita knowledge is transcendental? Because it is the knowledge about spirit, knowledge about the soul. So this in this Bhagavad Gita, Krishna, in the first three slokas, Krishna is calling this Bhagavad Gita as yogam. Yogam, yogam, yogam in many places. So even in the sixth chapter, Krishna is saying that yogi, tapasvibhyo adhiko yogi, jnanibhyopi matho adhikaga, karmibhyascha adhiko yogi, tasmat yogi bhava arjuna. So yogam, yogi. Yogi is a person who has achieved yoga. So that's what yogi is, a person who has achieved the status of yoga. So that's what he is known as yogi. Siddhya siddhyo samo bhutva samatvam yoga uchyate. So achieve the status of yoga means who has transcended the modes of material nature. That means who is freed from the dualities in this material world. So that's what is called yoga, yogi, yogam. So Krishna says that imam vivasvate yogam. I gave this knowledge to Vivasvan. Then Vivasvan Manave Praga Manur Ikshvakave Abravit. Then Sakale Nega Mahatta Yoga. So Mahatta Yoga. So this supreme great yoga, this Bhagavad Gita. So then in the next sloka, in the third sloka, in the fourth chapter, Krishna is saying that Yogaha Proktaha Puradana. Sayevaya Mayatya Yogaha Proktaha Puradana. So this yoga, which was told by me, which is the oldest language, oldest knowledge, basically. Puradhanaka. Puradhanaka means it is the oldest knowledge. So this Bhagavad Gita is the yoga which Krishna is teaching us. And we are getting this yoga. And by getting this knowledge, we will become yogis. So that's why tapasvibhyo adhiko yogi jnanibhyopi mato adhikaga karmibhyascha adhiko yogi tasmat yogi bhava arjuna. So that means yogi is above everything. Adhiko, adhiko means above. Tapasvibhyo adhiko yogi, a person who just undergoes austerities, penances. So yogi is above him. Tapasvibhyo adhiko yogi. And a person who just has the knowledge but not practicing. So jnani, jnanibhyopi mata adhikaga. Karmibhyascha adhiko yogi, a person who is just following, just going after the fruits of the results. Karmibhyascha adhiko yogi, tasmat yogi bhava arjuna. Therefore, you become a yogi. That's what Krishna is saying. That the last line is that tasmat yogi bhava arjuna. Yogi bhava means you become a yogi. Tasmat, therefore, you become a yogi. Then in the last sloka in the sixth chapter, Krishna says that योगिनामपि सर्वेषां मद्गतेनान्तरात्मना श्रद्धावान् भजते यो मां समे युक्त तमो मतः. Krishna is saying that out of all yogis, योगिनामपि सर्वेषां मद्गतेन अन्तरात्मा, who keeps me inside him, whose destination is only to reach me. That's what matgata. Matgatena antaratma. Sraddhavan bhajate yomam. Sraddhavan means with faith. Bhajate means worships. One who worships me with faith. Sraddhavan bhajate yomam. Same yukta tamo mataka. I consider him to be the most perfect yogi. Same yukta tamo mataka. So, when we get this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, that's what is this yoga. So this yoga is, this Bhagavad Gita is yoga. When we get this Bhagavad Gita knowledge, and then we practice, we follow what Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, and just offer everything unto Krishna. So that's what Sraddha, with the Sraddha, bhajate yoma. So that's what yoginam api sarvesa madgatena antaratmana. Siddhavan bhajate yoma. So with faith, we worship Krishna. So that's what is going to happen. When we get this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, we are going to worship Krishna. That's it. Because we know that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, without any doubt. This knowledge of Bhagavad Gita reveals us this very important fact that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. We will not have any doubt on that at all. Without any doubt. We know for sure, with complete knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, so we know that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. Then we worship Krishna. Then when we worship Krishna with faith, so Krishna is saying that I consider him to be the most perfect yogi out of all yogis. Yoginam api sarvesam. Out of all yogis, I consider him to be the most perfect. Same yukta tamo mataka. So that means, with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, we are going to become great yogis. That's what it means, simply. Simply with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, we will surrender unto Krishna. We know that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead without any doubt. And we will be completely surrendering unto Krishna with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. And when we surrender unto Krishna, when we worship Krishna, so that way our life, each and every moment, we will be connected with Krishna. So that way, we will be able to get ourselves away from this material sense objects, this materialistic world. In this materialistic world, people will run after material sense objects. We should not be one among them running after the material sense objects. So, with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, we should get ourselves out of this race. There is a race all the time in this material world to accumulate material things. People will be running and going and doing all kinds of activities and going after material sense objects. For devotee, it doesn't matter. Matter doesn't matter. That is the main thing. What matters to the devotee is only Krishna, only Bhagavad Gita, only service to Krishna. That's what is very important. So that is spiritual. Everything is spiritual. When we are connected with Krishna, when we are doing everything for Krishna, that means we are not attached to Bhoga and Aishwarya. We will be attached to Krishna. If you are attached to Bhoga and Aishwarya, Bhoga Aishwarya Prasaktanam, Taya Apagrita Chetasam, then vyavasayatmika buddhir samadav na vidyate. We are not going to get steady intelligence. Vyavasayatmika buddhi. So if we are attached to the bhoga and aishwarya. But if we are connected to Krishna, so Krishna prasaktanam, instead of bhoga aishwarya prasaktanam, if one is attached, one is connected to Krishna, Krishna prasaktanam taya apagrita chetasam, by which our consciousness is carried away, our thoughts are carried away, taya apagrita chetasam, then vyavasayatmika buddhi samadav vidyade. Here Krishna says that vyavasayatmika buddhi samadav na vidyade. Whereas if one is attached to Krishna, Krishna prasaktanam, Sri Bhagavan prasaktanam, so instead of bhoga aishwarya prasaktanam, we should be Sri Bhagavan prasaktanam, then also our consciousness, our thoughts will be carried away by Krishna. That is the main thing. So that means it will be filled with Krishna. So that's what is known as Krishna consciousness. So at that point of time, we are going to stay, get steady intelligence. That status is known as samadhi. So that's what samadho vidyade. Otherwise, samadho na vidyade. Vyavasayatmika buddhi samadho na vidyade. So that way, dhyayato Krishna pumsaga sangaste supajayate sangat sanjayate premaga. So bhakti. So sangat sanjayate prema, premat bhakti abhijayate. All such things we can say. Bhakti, devotion. Then our buddhi pariyavatistade. So buddhi will get established. But otherwise, nasti buddhi. Otherwise, buddhi naso. Buddhi naso means intelligence will be lost. So when we are in this material world, if we don't have the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, that means we don't know anything about ourself. We don't know about who am I. If we just identify ourselves with this temporary body, then if we think that we are this body, so then we will be fools. We will be doing all kinds of stupid activities in this world with attachment to material sense objects. But with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, Krishna gives us the intelligence, Krishna gives us the knowledge, and we will be able to focus our mind on Krishna. Our mind will be filled with Krishna because Krishna already is there in our heart. Krishna is residing in our heart, but Krishna should be there in our mind. That's what is very important. So if our mind should not be filled with all kinds of filthy thoughts, that's what is very important. If Krishna is not there, if we don't focus our mind on Krishna, then our mind will be filled with filthy thoughts. All kinds of attachments to this material world will make us to struggle and suffer and do all kinds of stupid activities in this world. Without the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, we will be just wasting our time. Every moment, each and every second, will be simply wasting. We'll be simply running here and there, going here and there, and doing all kinds of nonsense things. Everything is nonsense in this material world. If we don't have Krishna consciousness, if we don't know about Krishna, if we are not able to connect ourselves with Krishna, if we are not able to study Bhagavad Gita, not understanding Bhagavad Gita, have no knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, all such things makes us really in front of Krishna just fools without having any knowledge. But we are very, very fortunate. Krishna's mercy, we are getting this knowledge. As long as we are connected with Krishna, we are able to remember Krishna, we are able to think about Krishna, we are able to serve Krishna, then we will maya, the three modes of material nature will not bother us. Then our mind will be very peaceful. We can really find happiness within ourselves at that point of time only. Not when our mind thinks about material sense objects. If our mind thinks about material sense objects, if our mind is attached to material sense objects, then we are going to forget Krishna. So that way in this Bhagavad Gita, we are understanding all the knowledge, what we need. And Krishna is teaching us about yajna, the different types of yajnas one can do. So that's what we are going to study from now onwards. So we finished up to 24 slokas in the fourth chapter. So in the first, as I said, in the very first three slokas, Krishna mentioned about this yoga. Then Arjuna asked the question, how am I to understand it? You gave this knowledge in the beginning to Sun God Vivaswan. because by birth you are junior, whereas Vivasvan is senior by birth to you. Aparam bhavato janma param janma vivasvataka katam etat vijaniyam tvam adav proktavan iti. How am I to understand you gave this knowledge in the beginning to Vivasvan? So we understand very important fact, very important scientific fact. We understand for this question Arjuna asked. Every question is very important question Arjuna asked. Atakaina prayukto yam papam charati purushagam anichchanapi varshneya baladiva niyojitam. That's what in the third chapter we studied, in the 36th sloka. Arjuna asked the question, by what one is impelled to sinful acts unwillingly as if engaged by force? For that Krishna explained very nicely in the next 7-8 slokas. Krishna explained very nicely in the next 7 sloka. So now in the 4th chapter, when Krishna continued that he gave this knowledge to Vivasvan, Vivasvan gave it to Manu, Manu gave it to Ikshvaku. It was coming through disciplic succession. That disciplic succession was broken. Now he's giving that same knowledge to Arjuna. Then Arjuna is asking the question, how you gave this knowledge? Vivasvan is by senior, by birth. Then Krishna told that Bahuni me, Sri Bhagavan Vacha, Bahuni me vyatitani janmani tavacha Arjuna. Tanyakam veda sarvani natvam veta parantapa. So both you and me have taken many, many births in the past. Me, tava, me and you. Bahuni, many. Janmani, births. Vyatitani, past. So both you and me have taken many, many births in the past. Tanyakam veda sarvani. I know all of them. Natvam veta parantapa. But you don't know anything, O Parantapa, O conqueror of enemies. You don't know anything. That's what Krishna says. Then we study that Krishna, how Krishna's birth is very special. Krishna came himself and then Krishna is coming here. Krishna, whenever there is a decline in the righteousness and whenever there is a predominant rise of problems, irreligion and to establish, then to annihilate the miscreants, to protect the pious. So Krishna comes here. We studied. Then Krishna said that, you just understand the transcendental nature of my birth and activities, then you are not going to come back here. After you leave this body, then you will not come back here. That's what Krishna said. Then we studied about, Krishna explained very clearly about the karma. What karma is there? That's what we studied. Kim karma? Kim makarmeti kavyopyatra mohitaka tatte karma pravakshyami ajnatva mokshise asubha. So what is karma and what is akarma? Even the most intelligent persons are bewildered. So let me explain to you, by knowing which you will be freed from the miseries of material existence. That's where Krishna is teaching us. That's what we studied last week. Tyaktva karma pala sangam nitya tripto nirasrega karmani abhipravirtopi naiva kinchit karoti saga. So by giving up the attachment to the results of activities, tyaktva karma pala sangam nitya tripto nirasrega. So always satisfied without taking any shelter. So nitya tripto nirashega karmani abhipravirthopi naiva kinchit karoti. Even when we are doing any work, we are not doing anything. Nirasi yata chittatma tyakta sarva parigraha sariram kevalam karma kurvannapnoti kilbisham. So nirasir, without any desire, nirasir yata chittatma, tyakta sarva parigrahaka, by giving up all sense of proprietorship. Our only proprietorship should be only on Krishna. We own only Krishna. We don't own anything in this material world. So Krishna is our supreme personality of Godhead. So that's why nirasir yata chittatma, tyakta sarva parigrahaka, sariram kevalam karma, kurvannapnoti kilbasam. Just if we do the work only to maintain our body, then there is no sense. Yadrichalava santushto dvandvati to vimatsaraga samaga siddhau asiddhau cha kritva pinani badhyate. So by whatever gain we get on its own accord, yadrichalava santushto dvandvati to vimatsaraga, one is freed from the dualities, dvandvati to, and free from envy. Vimatsaraga, dvandva atito vimatsaraga, samaga siddhau asiddhau cha. One who is equal in both success and failure. Samaga siddhau asiddhau cha. Kritva api nani baddhyate. So when a person acts like that, he is not bound. गतसंगस्य मुक्तस्य ज्ञानावस्थित चेतसः यज्ञायाचरतः कर्म समग्रं प्रविलीयते. So when that happens, then all our attachments are gone. Gata sangasya. That means muktasya. That means we are liberated. Gata sangasya muktasya jnanavastita chetasa. So one who is situated fully in knowledge. So jnanavastita chetasa. Yajnayacharataka karma samagram praviliyate. So one who performs all the activities only as yajna. That means only as an offering unto Krishna. So he merges completely in the Supreme Brahman. So he gets into Krishna's well. So that's why all our activities should be performed as yajna. Now Krishna is going to teach different types of yajnas. That's what we are going to study today. We finished with this sloka number 24 in the fourth chapter, where Krishna said that Brahmarpanam Brahmakavihi Brahmagnau Brahmanahutam Brahmaiva Tena Gantavyam Brahma Karma Samadhina. So everything should be done for Brahma. So there is Krishna's about. There is Krishna. So Krishna is Brahma. Krishna is the Param Brahma. So everything should be done as an offering unto Krishna, as an yajna. So then we will go to Krishna. So that's what is very important. So doing everything as an yajna, doing everything as an offering unto Krishna will take us to Krishna. Otherwise, if we don't perform it as an yajna, as we studied in the third chapter, ninth sloka, Krishna said that yajnartat karmano anyatra lokoyam karma bandhan. Any other work, anyatra, it's going to bind us to this well. Anyatra lokoyam karma bandhan. So that's why tadartam karma kaunteya mukta sangaha samachara. Therefore, you perform your duty so that in such a way, without any attachment, so perform everything as an offering unto Krishna, everything as an yajna, so that you can freed from mukta sangha param prajet. We can freed from the attachment to this material world. So now, in the fourth chapter, 25th sloka, what we are going to study today, we are starting in the fourth chapter, 25th sloka. Devam eva pare yajnam योगिनः पर्युपासते ब्रह्माग्नौ अपरे यज्ञं यज्ञो नैवोपजुह्वति. देवमेव अपरे यज्ञं योगिनः पर्युपासते. सम योगीस दे विल डू ऑफर सैक्रिफाइसेस टू डेमिगॉड्स, बेसिकली वर्शिप दैवम. हियर कृष्णा व्हेन ही सेज दैवम हियर Krishna is referring to demigods. So we have seen people doing yajnas to demigods. So that's what devam eva pare yajnam yoginaga paryupasati. Then brahmagnav apare yajnam. Others apare. Apare means others. Others, they will do yajna to the Brahman. So that's what in the previous sloka also we studied. Brahma arpanam, Brahma haviya, all such things. So that's what brahmagnav apare yajnam yajno naiva upa juhvati. So, in the fire of Supreme Brahman. So, Krishna is going to now talk about different types of fires. We think that yajna means just the fire, what we make the fire, and then we offer everything into the fire. So, here Krishna is actually teaches different types of fire. So, here the fire of Brahman. So, that's what yajno naivo pa juhvati. Brahmagno. Agni means the fire. So, Brahmagno. So the fire of Brahman. Brahman means the absolute truth. So someone will, by doing the yajna, offer into the fire of Brahman. All offer sacrifices in the fire of Brahman. So that's why some yogis, devam eva pare yajnam yoginaga. Yoginaga means yogis. Some yogis, they offer to demigods. Some yogis, they offer to Brahman, that is Krishna. So then, in the next sloka, Krishna is continuing in the sloka number 26. Sotradin indriyananye samyamagnisu juvati sabdadin vishayananye indriyagnisu juvati. Sotra means hearing. So there is a hearing process, sotra. So that's why chanting is very important. So when we chanting, that's right, at the time of chanting, I already explained many times in the past, in the sixth chapter, Krishna is teaching us, one should sit straight, don't look at any other directions, his body, neck and head, everything in the same straight line. all such things. So manasamyamya matchitto yukta asita matpara. So at that time when we chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, we need to focus our mind on that sound. So that's what sound. So hearing. So we need to hear that sound. We need to hear that transcendental sound. So that's why Sotradini Indriyani. So Krishna is saying that all the senses, including Adini, means from the beginning. So Sotradini. So that is hearing process. All the Indriyas. So that's what Indriyani Anne. Samyamagnisu Jukvadi. So the fire of sense control. That's what Samyamagnisu. Samyama means it's fire controlling. That is restraint. Agnisu means fire. So in the fire of mental control. That's what the fire of sense control. So that's what Sotradin Indriyanyanya Samyamagnisu Jukvadi. So that means when we are chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, we are focusing our mind on the transcendental sound vibration. So that is an yajna. So there is an yajna because we are sacrificing everything only on that control. We are controlling all our senses. So that's what we are offering all our senses into that fire of sense control. So that is what is known as Samyamagnisu. Sabdadin Visiyanani. So Sotra means it's hearing. So that is the Indriya, senses. And Sabda means it is the sense object. So that's what we need to know. So sense object, Sabda. So for the hearing is the sense of hearing. That's what Sotra. Sotra means sense. It's hearing. That is the Indriyani. Indriyani means senses. Whereas Sabdadin Vishayan. Vishayan means sense objects. So that's what Sabdadin Vishayanani. So all the sense objects starting with Sabda. Sabda means sound. So sound vibration. So one who is Sabdadin Vishayanani, Indriyaginishu Jupadi. Indriyaginishu means the fire of senses. That's what Indriya Agnisu. So Indriya Agnisu means the fire of senses. So some will offer all the sense objects into the fire of senses. So that's what we are understanding. The fire of sense control and the fire of, basically the fire of mental control, as Srila Prabhupada has translated, and the fire of sense control, the fire of senses. That is Indriya Agnisu. That is Samyam Agnisu, Indriya Agnisu, Brahmagna. In the previous sloka, we studied about the Brahmagna, the fire of Brahman. Here, the fire of sense control and the fire of senses. So that's what each one different, like you are offering. Like in the fire of sense control, you offer the sense objects. In the fire of sense control, you offer the senses. In the fire of senses, you offer the sense objects. So that's what we are studying. So in the next sloka, Krishna is teaching in the sloka number 37. So, Sarvani Indriya Karmani Prana Karmani Chapare Atma Samyama Yoga Agnav Jugvati Jnana Deepite. So here, Jnana Deepam. Jnana Deepite means it is the fire here, the Jnana Deepa means the knowledge. Basically, it is the knowledge, the fire of, that is Samyama, then Sarvani Indriya Karmani. So all the activities, all the activities of our senses, everything. So they are, that is the function of all the senses, including the Prana Karmani. Sarvani Indriya Karmani means all the karmani, means all the activities, all the functions, including the prana karmani. Prana means our breathing, basically the life breath. So that's what the prana. Prana means the life breath. So prana karmani chapare atma samyama yoga agnav. So that is the atma samyama, means samyama means controlling the mind, the mind control. Yoga agnav. So this fire is called yoga agnav, in the fire of the yoga. So yoga means controlling our mind, being equal in both success and failure. So that's what Atma Samyama Yoga Agnav Jugvati. So Jugvati means they offer Jnana Deepite, because they are, because of the urge for self-realization. Jnana Deepite. So that's what Krishna is saying, that Sarvani Indriya Karmani Prana Karmani Chapare Atma Samyama Yoga Agnav. So we studied about different types of yajnas. Samyamagnu, Indriya Agnav, Brahma Agnav, Atma Samyama Yoga, Atma Samyama Yoga Agnav. So like that, Krishna is teaching us different fires. But we need to understand one thing very clearly. If we study Bhagavad Gita, if you follow what Krishna says exactly in Bhagavad Gita, so that means all these offerings, everything is already included. We don't have to separately do things, different offerings. So we just have to offer everything unto Krishna. So we have to do everything for Krishna. So with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. So for example, we are now doing this Jnana Yajna. So every day we are studying Bhagavad Gita. This is Jnana Yajna. So now in the next sloka, in the sloka number 28, Krishna is teaching there. Dravya Yajnaga Tapo Yajnaga Yoga Yajnastata Pare Swadhyaya Jnana Yajnascha Yatayaga Samsita Vrataga. So different types of yajnas Krishna is teaching us. Dravya yajna means offering one's possessions. That's what dravyam. Dravyam, you actually burn like light the fire and you put all the material things, the offerings, the possessions into there. So that's what is called dravyam, dravya yajna. Tapo yajna is the fire of austerities. That is sacrificing in austerities. That is tapa. Tapa means the austerity. That's what. Then yoga. Here yoga yajna, Krishna is referring to the yoga, what we do. The exercise for the body, we do that yoga. That's what yoga yajna tatapare. So others will do dravya yajna, tapo yajna, yoga yajna, swadhyaya jnana yajna. Swadhyaya means studying the Veda. Swadhyaya jnana yajna. So that is the jnana yajna. Even studying this Bhagavad Gita, that's what I mentioned, that we are doing jnana yajna now. So jnana yajna, swadhyaya jnana yajna cha yatayaga samsita vratagam. So others, they will actually do it. Yatayaga means they will endeavor, they will perform. So yatayaga samsita vrataga means who have taken strict vows. So vrata means it's vow. So samsita vrataga. So they will do it. So these are all the different types of yajnas Krishna is teaching us. But we need to understand, next week we'll study that sarvam karma akilam partha jnane parisamapyate. Everything culminates at the knowledge. So this knowledge is the very important thing. Afterwards, Krishna is going to, in the remaining chapter, in the fourth chapter, Krishna is going to focus more about this knowledge of this Bhagavad Gita. That's what is very, very important. So by Krishna's causeless mercy, we have successfully finished four slokas today. The sloka number 25 to 28 in the fourth chapter. Hare Krishna. I will stop now and we'll discuss if any questions are there. Hare Krishna.